destruction. With gravity-defying dives more intense than a roller coaster, it was the plane German pilots wanted to fly. This is the story of the Ju-87 Stuka. It was during Adolf Hitler's lightning attack on Poland in September 1939 that the Stuka dive bomber secured its infamous place in history. The successful invasion of Poland was secured using a military strategy known as Blitzkrieg, or lightning war. Just like the modern military tactics used during the two Gulf Wars, Blitzkrieg relied on successfully coordinating ground and air forces in a devastatingly fast attack. The Stuka was key to the operation. It was the first aircraft to drop a bomb and the first to shoot down an enemy plane. By the end of its first day in Poland, it had annihilated the Polish Air Force before most of their planes had even taken off. The secret of the Stuka's success was that it did something that virtually no other plane could do. Whilst most bombers dropped their bombs from thousands of feet up, the Stuka was able to swoop down until it was almost on top of its target and then release its bomb, increasing the chances of a direct hit. However, the very thing that made the Stuka so effective was also its most dangerous feature. When the Stuka went into a dive, the pilot was subjected to the kind of G-forces usually felt by astronauts on liftoff. This immense pressure was five times that of gravity and often caused the pilots to briefly go blind or black out at the very moment they were supposed to drop their bombs. To combat these potentially disastrous effects, German engineers designed an automatic pull-out and bomb release mechanism, which took over at the moment when a pilot was most likely to lose consciousness. The victories secured by Blitzkrieg made the Stuka infamous. The propaganda value of having a recognizable weapon that could bring fear to enemy troops and civilians was not lost on the Germans. After the early campaigns, the Stuka was fitted with a siren, which let out a terrifying sound as the plane dived at its target. Enemy troop formations were smashed, but not before they'd been demoralized by the screaming aircraft. Strong points were pulverized with remarkable accuracy, and columns of refugees were endlessly harassed as they fled. With its notoriety secured, the German propaganda machine set about making stars of Stuka pilots. Films and posters were produced elevating these airmen to the kind of celebrity status enjoyed by Lewis Hamilton and Fernando Alonso. As the German war machine rolled on, the Stuka was at the heart of the Third Reich's progress. It helped secure victories in Belgium, Holland and France and drove the British from the beaches of Dunkirk. Soon the Germans had achieved total domination over the skies of mainland Europe and the Stuka attacked Allied shipping in the English Channel. However, 1940 saw one of the Stuka's main weaknesses exposed. During the Battle of Britain, the Stuka was used to bomb airfields in England, but it proved very vulnerable to the fast, nimble, modern 8-gun Spitfire and Hurricane fighters of the Royal Air Force. 30 Stukas were shot down in just one operation, and they were quickly withdrawn from the battle. Returning to its more suited role in the support of ground forces, the Stuka was once again in the thick of the action during the invasion of Russia in the summer of 1941. By the middle of 1942, however, when the new Russian fighters appeared from their factories, Stukas were once again shot down in large numbers. Over the next few years, upgrades were made to the resilient Stuka. Extra armor was added for low flying, special tank buster guns were fitted under the wings, engine filters were included for desert use, and one model was even fitted with skis instead of wheels for landing on snow. In total, 5,700 were produced during the Second World War. Despite setbacks and heavy losses, the Stuka had proved its worth and flexibility as a weapon of war. It had dropped the first bomb of the war, and the Stuka dive bomber was still fighting in 1945 as Hitler's empire crumbled in the face of an overwhelming Allied force.